We're getting some new insight about what Americans think about the refugee crisis in Syria. A new Quinnipiac poll shows the majority of Americans oppose bringing Syrian refugees into this country. But the poll also finds a majority also oppose banning Muslims from entering the United States. John Hanna is former National Security Advisor to Vice President Dick Cheney and a senior fellow at the Foundation for Defense of Democracy. So, John, a lot's been said over this debate over the last several months. We have the political environment being what it is, with lots of folks running for president with a lot of different opinions. What do you think these numbers show us about where the American people are on this topic?
Well, I think it shows, Jenna, that the American people are in a pretty rational place, that they've identified a particular part of the world, Syria and Iraq, where ISIS is thriving and growing and being able to spread. And they've said that's a real problem for us, and we don't have faith that our government right now is able to vet people coming out of that that region of the world where so much of this terrorism is emitting from. And we've seen terrorists attack in Paris, in the heart of Europe. We've seen them here in the homeland. And I think the American people are properly saying, let's pause and let's see if our government can't get its hands around this and assure us that we're not taking undue risks here. And that makes sense to me.
You know, one of the other numbers shows that the Americans that were polled say that homegrown jihadists pose really the biggest threat, not those from abroad. And it's interesting, John just read that story about the Pennsylvania man who's in court today facing terrorism charges. What about that issue as we head into the new year, John? Have we properly addressed it? Do we have a good strategy in place?
I don't think so, Jenna. The president has finally, the last few weeks, actually begun to talk about this problem in a serious way. But I'm still not sure that I see a real strategy in any new steps that he's taking. First and foremost, I think, is just making sure that we're going to beef up the resources that our domestic law enforcement agency have, particularly the FBI. We know that there are now at least 900 cases across the country in all 50 states where we're trying to track homegrown jihadists that we've identified as a potential problem. And this is putting enormous strains on the FBI. It's clear that all of the lights are flashing red, and we've got to make sure these guys have got all the resources they need. And I haven't seen the president really focusing on that yet.
You know, it is interesting also to note, though, that Republicans, who are in charge of both houses of Congress, did vote through this huge bill that will also expand and further fund the refugee program, which is interesting, isn't it, John, considering the numbers you're seeing from the American people and the fact that there is bipartisan support to take a look at this program. What do you make of that decision politically, especially going into a new year where this is one of the concerns of the American people?
Yeah, I mean, everybody here is trying to achieve some kind of balance, something that's consistent with our history and our own moral vision as a country built on refugees and accepting people from abroad with this new world that we're living in, that we're all trying to adjust to, a world of terrorism and where the most dangerous terrorist groups in the world now have as a central part of their strategy an ability to exploit our vulnerabilities and our generosity to come here and change our way of life forever. And I think people are still very much in the mode of adjusting to that.
Well, hopefully we adjust quickly, because it seems that based on what we're getting from our leaders, this is a priority that we should look at. You know, Europe doesn't have the same time frame because they're confronting this migrant issue right now. And we were looking at some numbers. We just learned, in fact, that Europe has had at least a million refugees flooding into the continent just over the last year. The majority are from Syria, a fair amount from Afghanistan and Iraq. You also have a handful from Africa and South Asia. The largest number we now know are men coming without their families. We just did a segment yesterday, John. I would like to get your quick thoughts on this. The Council of Foreign Relations put together the survey and said this issue of migrants in Europe is a big issue for us just because of terrorism, the terror threat, but also political instability it could cause the continent. What do you think about that?
I think that's absolutely right. Europe is under threat. I mean, the very idea of a common European space is falling apart, is fracturing under the stresses of both this refugee problem, this terrorism problem, and very weak economies. And let's face it, Europe has been the central pillar of the transatlantic relationship that has upheld the American-led world order since World War II. And if Europe falls apart, if Europe fractures and isn't able to live up to its responsibilities as an ally of the United States, that world order is in big trouble. It will unravel, Jenna, and we will all suffer the consequences.
Interesting. That might be where we need to keep an eye on the refugee issue, even more so than here at home. Great to see you, John. Merry Christmas.
Thanks. You too, Jenna.